Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the United States Naval War College graduation ceremony for the Naval Command and Staff online program, Fall Quarter Class of 2020. I am Professor Walt Wildeman, and I am the Dean of the Naval War College's College of Distance Education, the college under which the Naval Command and Staff online program is organized and administered. And I am your MC for today's proceedings. During the summer of 2020, we decided to conduct quarterly virtual graduation exercises because we wanted to recognize our Naval Command and Staff online program graduates in a more timely and specific manner than just including them in the large overall Naval War College graduation program each June. Therefore, today, we will recognize the graduates with this virtual ceremony, during which everyone is encouraged to use the chat feature and the clapping hand icon to congratulate the graduates throughout the ceremony. As a final note, I would ask the graduates to please let your professors know what you think about the ceremony, as we welcome your suggestions on any way we might improve on it for future classes. Thank you. And now please rise, or should I say, attention to the singing of our national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming. And the rocket's red glare, the balls bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh,
it is now my pleasure and distinct honor to introduce Rear Admiral Shoshana S. Chatfield, the 57th President of the United States Naval War College. Admiral Chatfield.
Thank you so much, Dean Wildeman. I want to thank each and every one of you for logging on today to participate in this virtual graduation ceremony. To our honored guests, thank you. We would love to welcome you in your future travels to Newport. And we understand that all of you have done extraordinary things to accomplish your normal business during this COVID time. I'd like to give a few call outs right now for people that I know that will watch or are watching at the moment. So to our esteemed colleague, Mr. George Lang, who heads up our Naval War College Foundation, want to say thank you to all of your membership for your incredible generosity to our organization. We have both faculty, staff, and especially our students have benefited tremendously from your activities and your generosity. To Dean Wildeman and to Professor Sexton, thank you very much for inviting me to speak today and to have me on this format. Thank you for the effort that you put into creating and executing this program, along with our fabulous mission support team who have come together to produce this event. And now to our acting provost, Jay Hickey, to our deans and faculty members, thank you for a continuous effort put forward on behalf of our college and our students. You have done so much to prepare for the course content and the delivery of this education. You have anticipated the needs of our students and all of their agencies, and today you see before you the fruits of your labor. You have educated and developed these leaders, and that effort will pay dividends in their professional and personal lives and in our organization moving forward. Thank you for your dedication and your service. And to our families and friends of today's graduates, thank you for participating today. Thank you. I know you're both near and far in this time zone and many other time zones, but you're making time to share in this celebration of a great achievement, which comes at great effort. We know that this time invested in education has come as a trade-off with other things that your student may have done. And we wanted to say thank you. Their investment will be appreciated for many years. And I want to really personally say that we know that families and friends provide immense support for service members. And so we know that this is just one of the things that you've done, and we wanted to say thank you. And now to our graduates from the Naval Command and Staff online program. I know that this was an extra effort. I know that because I'm also a graduate of the distance education program here at the Naval War College. So in addition to your day job, you've taken on passionately the pursuit of your education. You carried that into the evening hours. You did that on weekends. You've done readings. You've done collaborative work, you've done research, you've written, and you've done it all so that you could complete and succeed in this program. That's a sacrifice, and I wanted to say thank you. I commend you for doing that, for choosing to do that, and for all of the things that you learned along the way. We asked you to think critically, to put on different lenses, whether it be strategy, whether it be looking at things through a lens of diplomacy, ethics, history, operational art. And you tried those things out. And through that process, you developed an enhanced way of thinking critically and of developing frameworks to outline what the problem is and how to solve it. And I know that there will be a myriad of challenges in the future that you will have to tackle, and that you'll be doing this in support of your own unit and maybe even on a grander scale to support our national security apparatus. And you'll draw from the diverse experiences that you had in this program. There's 183 people have graduated in this quarter. And so with them, you join our alumni, which have been accumulating over these past 136 years. And now you're part of that community. And so I want to welcome you into that community. And I want to encourage you to continue your journey of education. Don't stop now. Don't assume that this was it, that you're going to camp out now with these concepts and these frameworks. take what you've learned and push to the edge of what you know and try. Find opportunity to collide with other people in their expertise. It is that area right on the margin where you will innovate, where the integration of your thinking with someone else's will create an advantage, possibly a strategic advantage for your organization or for our great joint force. During this time that you've been enrolled, we have also seen an incredible attention placed on issues of social justice, of equality in our nation, of access to resources, and the real benefits of being an American under our Constitution. We saw that this sparked an interest and a movement globally, where our commitment to equality, access to prosperity, and equal treatment under the law has been taken up and echoed in countries around the world. And I ask you to think about inclusion and diversity as you move forward in your organizations. Throughout this time, in this very uncertain time and changing world, we heard from our senior leaders about how much they value education and how much they're counting on education to deliver strategic advantage to our forces. And our senior leaders do recognize that your investment in your education is a direct contribution to our U.S. Navy warfighting advantage. Your charge now is to commit to the transformative power of education, to link what you've learned to how we operate and how we fight, how you will frame problems, and how you will develop and assess solutions in the future. Take what you learned here, how to think through a different lens, how to view the challenges that you will inevitably face in the future. Take that strengthened intellect, those improved analytical skills, and your expanded perspective, and fold that into the leader that you are becoming. To all of you who graduate today, I challenge you to continue that growth and that success through participation in our alumni community. Please stay connected with each other, with your faculty, and with us here in Newport. And to all our friends and families online today, again, I want to say thank you to you. Thank you for that support that you've given to your student, who you have shared with us. And I know that today you are as proud of that student as I am. For this graduating class, I want to lend my congratulations also to be so proud of you for your accomplishment. Congratulations.
Thank you, Admiral Chatfield, for those inspirational remarks. And now I have the honor to present the United States Naval War College Naval Command and Staff Fall Quarter Class of 2020. They have been thoroughly examined and approved by the faculty.
By the power vested in me by the Congress of the United States, the Chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff, and the New England Commission of Higher Education, I confer upon you the College of Naval Command and Staff Diploma and Joint Professional Military Education Phase 1 certification from the United States Naval War College, with all the honors, rights, and privileges pertaining thereto.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in saluting in the chat room, as many of you are now doing, the graduates of the United States Naval War College Fall Class of 2020 and their families and friends. Thank you. Congratulations, graduates and families. You all should be rightfully proud. We now have two special guests who would like to acknowledge the accomplishments of the graduates.
Greetings from the Pentagon. I'm Vice Admiral Lisa Franchetti, Director for Strategy, Plans, and Policy on the Joint Staff, better known as the J5. This directorate proposes strategies, plans, and policy recommendations to the Chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff to support his military advice across the full spectrum of national security concerns to the President, the Secretary of Defense, and other national leaders. The team here is made up of creative professionals like you who are able to translate today's uncertainty into tomorrow's strategy. Congratulations on this accomplishment. You should all be very proud of everything you've achieved, and I hope you are excited and ready to apply and build upon what you've learned. As a fellow Naval War College graduate, I know how hard it is to complete these academics while balancing all other aspects of your life, made even more difficult by the pandemic. Thank you for making this effort. You and our joint force will be better and stronger because of it. As this chapter of learning comes to an end, let me leave you with one thought. Oliver Wendell Holmes once said, and I'm paraphrasing, every now and then a person's mind is stretched by a new idea and it never shrinks back to its former dimension. I hope the War College has indeed stretched your mind and you continue to take the time to read, study, and build on what you've learned. For us to have what it takes to win in the future, we need you to do just that. Again, congratulations on achieving this important milestone in your development. I wish you, your families, and your support networks all the best in the future and hope to see you in the fleet and the joint force someday.
Hi, I'm Rear Admiral Jay Bynum, Acting Deputy Chief of Naval Operations for Warfighting Development. While it's not likely you'll remember who I am or what I say today, I'm going to ask you to try to remember one thing. So hold up your index finger right now. That's right, you are number one today. Congratulations on completing your War College experience. Every time you hold up this one finger in the future, whether at a sporting event or somewhere else, I ask you to remember one thing, integrity. It's the foundation of good leadership. So whenever you see this, think of that. And oh, by the way, if you remember me or what I said, track me down in a few years. I'll buy you a cup of coffee. Congratulations.
And now I would like to introduce Professor Julia Gage, the Naval War College Director of Alumni Programs. Julia.
Well, I don't know that I can advocate better for our alumni community. We're all going to be in trouble. I'll be pointing at everybody. Everyone will think I'm rude, but I think that that's wonderful. Welcome, welcome to the Alumni Network. We look forward to, that's a snowplow. One of those days. Anyway, we look forward to welcoming you into the larger community. In addition to all of you graduating today, we do, my goodness, I think it's about 4 large graduations a year. And just like you, everyone is hungry to continue their lifelong learning. And so I encourage you to join our alumni portal. It's myusnwc.com. And in there, you will find a plethora of resources for your toolbox as you progress through your career. But I think, and I hope that you will as well, I think it's really the networking and it's the engagement with other alumni. When we say a robust community, there's actually depth to that. There's a lot of different people. And actually, again, you'll find a place to collide in a warm way, but a place to collide with like-minded people and people that have different views. But the one thing in common is you've all studied the same materials and you're all on relatively the same career trajectory. So I look forward to seeing you all on myusnwc.com, and please let me know and engage, and we will better, more better, and exactly what you want. It's your community. So thank you again. Congratulations and good luck.
Thank you, Julia. We in the College of Distance Education are very happy and proud that we were able to add another 183 graduates to your alumni database. Yoo-hoo. Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes today's ceremony. Best wishes for a nice day. If you're not in Newport, a nice day. It's rather cold and snowy here. A celebratory weekend ahead and a joyous holiday season. Thank you for attending.